how do we introduce this this act? Mike Watt in studio.
Hey! real old my.
Brother Jimmy. Woo! On the guitar, Todsky. Woo! I'm Watt from Pedro. Another day.
nobody. Another year for me and you. It's
wouldn't have a movement without the Stooges. Love Stooges. And we drove 25 miles from Pedro, but it was worth it. Thank you so much for having us aboard. The best show, the big show. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Jimmy Totsky and all of you for helping us help celebrate Stooges in our life. Separated, baby, far too long. Oh, no, you will see pretty thing of your diamonds. Throw me your ring, champagne, baby.
That was just otherworldly.
Stooges.
Unbelievable.
And getting to celebrate it with Todd and Jimmy from Toys That Kill is very happy. And thanks truly for letting us come to the Val and do it.
Yeah, it sounded insane. It sounded so good, Mike. I got to tell you.
I was kind of mad. You know, there was no bass, so in the I was kind of maiming. A little braille. That's all right. Poor Carpenter blames his tools, so we I'm got just the, glad for I'm t- the old word opportunity and not to be word burden.
The bass was there, my friend.
Like Mr. Chaplin said.
The bass was there, my friend. I'm telling you. I was listening in here. That was heavy duty. What a special thing. Thank you so much for
that. Alexander, Ron Ashton, some incredible bass people.
Yeah, and it's just beautiful for you to fly the flag with those songs. That's like, I mean, that's just American music now. That's just the same as Scott Joplin.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's Stooge music is, and it comes from all kinds of places, you know, just Jim Brown is Motown. There's Pharoah Sanders, who's John Coltrane. There's lots of fucking Link Wray.
Absolutely.
I remember he told me when he heard Rumble, a song that was banned on U.S. radio.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not even fast, right? It's a slow song, but they thought it was going to bring out the worst of people and instead did the opposite, inspired people.
That music brings people together.
Freak flag fly, right.
Absolutely. And what, you remember the first time you heard Stooges?
Yeah, it was in the early 70s. I was just a teenager, you know, I was 13 in 1970. So when I heard Funhouse first, and it was kind of trippy, but it was getting me ready for the movement because at that time, the big Michigan band was something called Grand Funk Railroad.
Sure.
With somebody you never even hear of hardly now, but Stooges, everyone hated it. They thought it was, and I'm talking about even people wrote in the things. I mean, they revised all their trips.
Mm-hmm.
But in the day, they said it was not happening. And so I took a lot of blows for it. But in a couple of years, you know, me, Georgie D. Boone, we graduated in 76. So Stooges prepared us for the movement.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think them and Captain Beefheart, people like this, they were doing punk in the way before, they just didn't have a name for it. So, mm-hmm. And you know, at the end of the day, music is music. And like you were saying, it's to bring people together.
Absolutely. And it is just, and one of the great things is that you are on that continuum of.
Oh, we all are. We're, you know, it's you're either on the last shift or next shift or this mm-hmm. shift.
Yeah. Well, you're the big boss on the shift. You're on the shift, and we all...
I was lucky. I got to meet D. Boone. He jumped out of a tree. We were 12 years old, and they thought I was his neighbor, and it was a sea change in my life for sure.
Yeah, he asked if you were an Eskimo.
Yeah, that was the nickname for his neighbor. Really sweet guy.
Yeah.
I can't remember his name. Cervantes. You know, in those days, because I come from Navy housing, no one had first names. So.
Mm-hmm.
That was... But he was a sweet guy, but D. Boone had bad eyes, and I was not Eskimo, and... But it turned out to be, yeah.
Yeah.
His ma, the next day, I visited him at his house, and his ma says, you guys are going to have a band, and you're going to play bass. I didn't even know what bass was. Neither did he. But she said every band needed one, and so I can't thank her enough.
Well, at this point, you clearly know what a bass is.
A little bit. Learning.
Learning. Well, I got to say, that was an honor.
It stayed in a bit, you know. Somebody, I was on maybe a month ago, the Dodgers radio guys, one of them's Pedro, and they were there in Pedro, and they asked me to come on there. And Petros and Money, right? The Petros guy's Pedro, so old Greek family. The Money guy asked me, now, what's the bass trying to do, what? And I said, on stage, the closest note is the kick drum, right? So what we're trying to do is get the bass guitar and the kick drum to dance. Mm-hmm. They can dance with each other, then it's a success for the rest of the band. To get their freak flag flying.
Yeah, yeah. What's it like to be inside those songs?
Yeah, it's intense. You got a responsibility. You got to move the people. You know, drums, bass, it's not as much as listen and feel sometimes. A lot of feel. And people know, listeners, gig goers, as well as the cats you're on stage with. It's a trippy thing. It's a glue. You know, what's glue with nothing to stick to? Just a puddle. So we don't want to be that.
No.
We want to put it all, you know, people go to the head and they sit there doing what they do. And most of them look at the tile. Well, I look at the grout, you know, because bass is grout, us and the drummer.
Mm-hmm.
And our politics are great, man. We look good making them look good. So
yeah, no. That. One of the biggest thrills was when the Stooges pulled it back together and you were holding it down for them.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That was incredible. Ig and Ronnie hadn't talked in 29 years.
Yeah. But and, well,
Jay Mascus, in a way, got that happening because I was helping him out after the sickness almost killed me with his Jay Mascus in the Fog. And when we came through Ann Arbor, I had recorded with Ronnie, and Ronnie'd come to my Minuteman gigs and stuff in Greektown, part of Detroit. He says, "You call up Ronnie." So he comes down to the Blind Pig and he jams some Stooges with us. So Jay says, "Come on tour with us." So two thirds would be Jay's stuff, and then we do last third Stooges with Ronnie. Mm-hmm. And then Thurston was curating some all tomorrow's party, and hey, rent Scotty a drum set. You know, he was living in his truck at this time.
Mm-hmm.
So I get me and Jay get to play with both Ashton brothers, and Ig hears about this, and that's where he called up Ronnie.
Yeah.
And so I got to give credit to Jay, but I got to give credit for Ronnie, because when I got the call from Ig, I was on tour with my second man. I was in Tallahassee at the, I think it was the second Cowhouse after sound check. I answer the phone at the bar, you know, no leashes yet, mm-hmm. not for Watt at least. And it's Ig, and he says, "Hey, Ronnie says you're the man." And I couldn't believe it. And he says, "Would you do me a favor and wear a T-shirt instead of a flannel?" I said, yeah, it's John Fogerty's idea anyway. I said, "What about Levi and Converse?" He says, "That's strong." So it was Ronnie that got me in there. He mm-hmm. told Ig, yeah, I couldn't believe those words. And I thought one gig, right, Coachella, 2003, that would be it. And it turned into 125 months I got to serve with him.
Unbelievable.
Finally the youngest guy in the band. And to work that Stooge music. And a lot of people at the gigs were not their age. They were, in fact, much younger than I am.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, because I think people are curious about where did this music come from? What are these guys about? Because, like I said, in the day, they weren't too liked.
No.
But that shows to go you, man. If something's happening, maybe it takes, you know, like Orson Welles said, that two-buck Chuck Masson brother, you know, no wine before it's time. And maybe that's what it took all them years.
Yeah. I saw you at when Little Steven had that thing out.
Oh, yeah, right. Randall Island.
One of the most magical things I've ever seen is when Iggy was like, "Get up on this stage," and that crowd surged.
No fun and a real cool time. He had the cats come up there.
And it was just all positive, though. Everybody rushed that thing, and they were feeling it. They were all deep into it, too. Everybody was
very
connected.
Very kind to us. Very kind. No ageism. That's trippy about music. You know, when I was a teenager in the 70s, you wouldn't listen to stuff even 5 years old. Young people now, I mean, things ain't perfect and stuff, but, man, are they way more open-minded.
Yeah.
About, you know, and that's... And you listen to Funhouse. It could have been recorded next week. It don't sound like 1970. It's not happy. It ain't Fonzie and Potsy kind of crap, you know?
Yeah, no. The Stooges music could be 50 years from now.
Well, Reed Leaves of Grass, right? Walt Whitman, 1855. And that's not old-timey.
No.
I Sing the Body Electric. Made a poem out of his body.
Yeah.
I mean, timeless things like that. And sometimes... It's not all conspiracy or it's not all genius. Sometimes it's just things coming together at the right time in the right place. And I think that's what Stooges was. You know, Little Doll, that bass is the same thing in Pharoah Sanders, Upper Egypt, Lower Egypt. It's a trip about arts.
Yeah. It's a beautiful thing. And
it's a fabric. We can connect humans without having some fascist kind of hierarchy. Nobody has to have their foot on anybody's throat.
No.
Yeah.
It just is, and you are...
Like a good-looking flannel, a lot of different threads to make interesting.
Yeah, and you're keeping it alive, and you have been just... You just meant so much to me and so much to all of us for so long. It's a true honor to have you here, and to hear you play those songs is it's a thing of beauty, and I can't thank you enough.
You're very welcome.
What a just a masterpiece of a day to get to see that. In front of me.
I'll tell you this, because we're on this side of the Hollywood Hills, the Val side people, not the Pedro side, 25 miles south in the harbor. But Scotty, Rock Action, right, the drummer of the Stooges, I was driving him around Hollywood, and he had me drive up to, like I said, this side of the Hollywood Hills, where the Stooges lived after the Rob, doing the Raw Power album. They came up and was doing gigs at the Whiskey and stuff, and he showed me the house that Main Man rented for them. And you couldn't see the Hollywood, Los Angeles side. It was the Val side.
Wow, wow.
Yeah, so I got, you know, when I was around them, my ears were like elephant size and like sponges soaking up.
Yeah.
It was like I could go right to the well, right to the source, you know? It was not second, third hand. I was so lucky. So the more I can spread Stooge music, Stooge philosophy, you know, listen what he says in Funhouse. You know, we came to play.
Yeah.
Four words. Econo.
Yeah. Yeah. No, you're moving it forward. You're keeping it alive. It's a generational thing, and you're keeping it alive generation to generation. This is a true American culture, and you flying the flag for this stuff means the world to all of us. So I want to thank you personally and collectively. Thank you so much, Mike. You're a true legend and a true sweet soul, and I will never be able to thank you enough for what you've done for music.
You're most welcome. It makes me want to play even harder and make it count.
Yeah, you know, it's like if you're leaning, you could be cleaning, and that's what I think of when I think of you jamming at Econo. You take a day off. There's no such thing as a day off. And we're not taking days off here anymore on this show. I'm doing 24 hours. I've slept. Yes. I haven't slept.
Respect.
I haven't slept since 7:30 yesterday. At 7:30 a.m. is the last time I slept. We're making the push here 24 hours to get people, get eyes on this show, get eyes on this music.
Yeah.
Can't thank you enough, Mike. Oh, total honor.
Most kind.
You know, I'm honestly trying to fight back a little some tears here. Oh. That's what you mean to me, buddy.
Oh, big love.
Yeah. Well, you did it. Can't thank you enough. You want anything? You want something to drink? You want some? We got a fridge back there. You take anything you want. It's all yours.
Okay.
You take the fridge. You want to take the fridge, you take the fridge.
I'll leave the fridge. But I'll take some of the consumable wet stuff.
Go for it. It's got your anything in there, it's got your name on it.
Okay.
Yeah. It's true. Game true honor, Mike.
Game to play.
Love it. Love it. Okay. You cast a shadow over all of us.